Sleep is important for physical and mental health as well as overall well-being. It supports many processes, including learning, memory, and attention. In children without epilepsy, sleep problems occur up to a rate of 40% in early childhood. However, in children with epilepsy, these rates can be higher and have a worse impact on their diagnosis. Despite this, the importance of good sleep is not yet fully acknowledged or understood, despite it being an important determinant of quality of life in children with epilepsy and their families. My name is Alice Winsor, and I am a PhD student here at the Centre for Human Brain Health, investigating the relationship between sleep and quality of life in children with epilepsy. Our project is supported by the Waterloo Foundation and looks at two primary aims. The first is to really understand how does sleep affect and how is it affected by daytime function, behaviour and quality of life. The second aim is to really look into the electrophysiological aspect of epilepsy, so the brain activity and its relationship with sleep. We understand that sleep and epilepsy have a bi-directional relationship. On one side, sleep can impact epilepsy, so children who do not achieve enough sleep are more vulnerable to further seizures, and so therefore poor sleep acts as a precipitating factor. Now, there are various reasons for poor sleep. One can be poor sleep hygiene, or possibly more of an underlying medical reason, such as sleep disorders, which in the case of children with epilepsy, these are highly common and they often go undetected. On the other branch of this relationship, epilepsy can impact sleep. So nocturnal seizures can affect the continuity during the sleep cycle, causing children to wake up during the night. But also there's evidence to suggest that even in children with seizures during the day, there is still an impact on their sleep, highlighting more of that intrinsic effect of epilepsy and its impact on the brain on sleep. There are also factors such as epilepsy medication, which can either improve or decrease sleep, depending on the type of medication. Now, as part of our research, we are working with two hospitals, the Birmingham Children's Hospital and Worcester Royal Hospital. And here we are recruiting families whose children are going in for a video EEG assessment. And this is conducted while the child sleeps to identify any seizures which may help to form an epilepsy diagnosis. If families consent to take part in our research, they're required to complete a series of questionnaires assessing behaviour, quality of life and sleep in the child and in the parent. As part of our study, the child is also required to wear a watch, and this is a sleep watch which records the child's sleep during the 2-week period, and it really allows us to have a more deep understanding of their habitual sleep patterns. As part of this research, we also have a meta-analysis. So a meta-analysis is a quantitative synthesis of different studies, bringing together all these different results to form set conclusions. Our meta-analysis was really looking again to form the foundation of our project to look at sleep in epilepsy and to compare these findings with children without epilepsy. This meta-analysis is now in the process of being published online, and we found really interesting results. So with looking across different sleep measures, so parent-reported sleep measures, the sleep watch type of data, and also EEG type of data, so again, the brain activity during sleep, we found that children with epilepsy had significantly reduced total sleep time in comparison to children without epilepsy of around 34 minutes on average. We also found that they had reduced sleep quality and also experienced higher percentage of lighter sleep, highlighting that they're not achieving as much of that deep restorative sleep compared to children without epilepsy. And finally, we found that the children with epilepsy had significantly higher, more frequent and more severe sleep problems in the domains of night awakening, parasomnia, so these are, for example, sleepwalking and sleep talking, and also sleep disordered breathing. So our findings really highlighted that, again, children with epilepsy are very much vulnerable to sleep patterns, whether they're measured objectively and subjectively, and really pointed to that message that it does require clinical acknowledgement, and sleep problems should be screened at an early stage in the epilepsy diagnosis to improve epilepsy management and epilepsy care. And this can also have an area for future research to look to investigating areas for intervention. So if we improve sleep, are we able to improve seizure control? Thank you for listening. If you want to hear more about our research and what we do, please do go to my Twitter page, which is Windsor_Alice, and also check out the Centre for Human Brain Health website, which highlights all the amazing research we do here at the university. Thank you.